Hi students, very good morning. Today in this lecture we are going to deal regarding osmotic pressure. Before going into the osmotic pressure, let us differentiate the two terms called as diffusion as well as osmosis. Okay, so if you see the term diffusion, already you have learnt in your 11th standard itself with respect to the diffusion, where you will be seeing with respect to gases, you have seen that. Okay, so we can say what is meant by diffusion means movement of any substance from region of their higher concentration to the lower concentration. Means there is a movement of particles. Where it should be higher concentration, from there the particles will be moving to the lower concentration. Means where the availability of that particular solute particles is very low. Okay, we have applied for the gases. Suppose if we take for the solutions, take this is a container has been divided into two compartments. In one compartment you are having solution C1, this is concentration C1. In another compartment you are having solution C2. Concentration is different. What is meant by the concentration? The number of moles present in given volume, it is called as concentration. So in this I am representing C1 concentration, in this I am representing C2 concentration. Okay, and I am representing saying that in C1 solute is excess, means always concentration is represented with respect to the solute particles, number of solute particles. If more the number of solute particles, then it is called as higher concentrated solution. If number of particles are low, then it is called as lower concentration solution. So among C1 and C2, I am telling this one, this concentration is higher, means the number of solute particles in this concentration are very higher. In this, in C2, the number of solute particles are low, means what you can say, the solvent particles are more in number, you can say here. Okay. Now if you go for the osmosis, the reverse of this one. See, you will be getting doubt here. Yeah, C1 to C2, what you are saying, the movement of higher particles, the movement of particles from higher concentration to lower concentration, means what does that indicate? The particles are moving from C1 to C2. Now my question arises here is, are the particles, solute particles are moving from C1 to C2 or C2 to C1 or both? Means the answer is both. So the solute particles will move from here to here. Here also the solute particles will move from here to here. Both, that there will be movement of particles. Up to when there will be movement of particles? Until when the both the concentration in both the compartments will be equal. Okay students, are you getting this? Now if I go for the osmosis, and the osmosis, it is represented as see, in the between two compartments you have separated with a wall, right? That wall is called as membrane. Okay, in osmosis this is more use. See, in this osmosis, same, the container, it is having two compartments. One is concentration C1, another is concentration C2. C1 is greater than C2. And this concentration is represented with respect to number of solute particles. Here I am saying that movement of solvent particles from lower concentration of solution to the higher concentration of the solution is called as osmosis. See, lower concentration means where the number of particles are very low. Solute particles, here C1 means number of solute particles are very high. What I am telling, osmosis is that process which the solvent molecules, see, solution means it is nothing but the combination of solute plus solvent, right? Here only the movement of solvent particles is present, and the movement of solvent particles are moving from low concentration to the high concentration solution. Okay. Okay, and the membrane, whatever this is, accepting the solvent particles to pass through that, it is called a semi-permeable membrane. And sometimes instead of semi-permeable membrane, they use it to take animal membrane and sometimes cellophane paper. And that cellophane paper formula is Cu2FeCN6. This is the coordination complex, right? See, what I am saying is, osmosis is that process where the movement of the solvent particles will occur. See, in the above case, with respect to diffusion, what we have said, higher concentration to lower concentration. Now with respect to osmosis, it is from lower concentration to higher concentration, and that too movement of only solvent particles through a semi-permeable membrane. This is called as osmosis. Again I am repeating, osmosis is a process where there is a movement of solvent particles from a lower concentration to the higher concentration through a semi-permeable membrane. This membrane, this semi-permeable membrane, it allows only the movement of the solvent particles from either of the solution. The solvent particles may go from here to here, or the solvent particles may go from this solution to this solution. Nothing happens. Only this can accept only the solvent particles to pass through on to the either side. Okay. So if the concentration of the solution is low, means the concentration of the solvent will be higher in that. Okay. See, now I can say movement of solvent particles from lower concentration of solution to the higher concentration of the solution, or movement of solvent particles from higher concentration of the solvent to the lower concentration of the solvent. Both are the correct only, right? They will be moving into the both until the concentration becomes equal. Okay, that is semi-permeable membrane. Remember the students, this accepts only the movement of the solvent particles. Okay, right. Now I am representing, now we are clear with the osmosis. What is mean by osmosis? The movement of the solvent particles from lower concentration of the solution to the higher concentration of the solution through a semi-permeable membrane. So let me take here, only solvent is present here, semi-permeable membrane is present here, and this is the solution. Means solution is having both the solute as well as solvent. So from which direction, from where to where you can expect the movement of the solvent particles? So from here to here, means from solvent to the solution, there will be a movement of solvent particles. Okay, so what happens if the solvent particles comes here and it rises? If you keep a piston here, as the number of solvent particles are increasing in this container, it tries to push up this piston. Okay, now what you are applying, instead of this piston is will be trying to move upwards, now you are applying some pressure so that the piston is not moving. So how much pressure you are keeping on the piston, it is equal to the pressure whatever that is exerted by the solvent molecules coming into this container. Okay, the solvent molecules are coming into this container and they are exerting pressure on the piston, and you are going on increasing the weight on the piston so that the piston will not move upward or downward. It is maintaining balance here. Okay, if from some this side, if solvent molecule increases, it increases some pressure so that you will be increasing on the top also. So what happens here, the pressure whatever developed due to the solvent molecules is balanced here. Based on the weight you are placing here, you can calculate how much pressure is exerted by the solvent molecules on this solution. So that pressure, whatever that is experienced by this piston, this has come due to the osmosis process, and that pressure exerting on the piston, it is called as osmotic pressure. Clear? The solvent molecules coming into this container through a semi-permeable membrane, and they are exerting pressure on the piston so that the piston should move upward. So as to counterbalance that pressure, you are placing some weight on this piston continuously so that the piston will not move outward. If outside weight you are keeping is very less, what happens? It pushes the inward liquid, pushes upward. This one moves from the particular point. If you are increasing more, what happens? This piston comes downward. Okay, you are not giving more weight or you are not giving less weight. You are giving the equal weight so that it is in this place only. Okay, how much weight is placed? That is the pressure exerted by the solvent molecules on the solution. That pressure is called as osmotic pressure, because this pressure has come into the solution due to the osmosis process. And in form of definition, it is explained in this way. The net movement of the solvent molecules from solvent to the solution. See, movement molecules are coming. Solvent molecules are coming from solvent to the solution. Can be stopped. You are stopping the movement of this one. They are coming into this one. Okay, after coming that, it is exerting pressure on that. You are stopping the movement of this piston. Okay, means you are the net movement of the solvent molecules coming into the solution. You are stopping it by applying some extra pressure on this. That pressure, whatever that you have applied, so as to stop the movement of the solvent molecules into the solution, that pressure is called as osmotic pressure. That is, the extra pressure over solution side which stops the osmosis is called as osmotic pressure. Means what happened? Due to osmosis it will be coming. So that if osmosis occurs, the level will be increased. So as to stop the increase in the level of the water, what happens? You should place some weight there so that the water entrance into the solution will be reduced. Okay, that is called as osmotic pressure, and they have calculated that osmosis pi osmotic pressure is represented with pi. Pi is directly proportional to the concentration of the solution, and pi, it is directly proportional to the temperature. Concentration is nothing but molarity, and temperature is taken in Kelvin, and you know that concentration can be, so we can write it as pi directly proportional to m into t. If you remove the proportionality, you can place it with r, and you know that pi is equal, concentration is mean nothing but number of moles per volume. So number of moles per volume, so if you send this here, you will be getting PV is equal to NRT. The same equation what you will be seeing with respect to the ideal gas. Okay students, see, based on this we will be solving some questions. Now calculate the osmotic pressure due to 5% weight by volume cane sugar at 15 degrees centigrade. Options A, 2.8 atmospheres, 3.4, 4.2 and 6 atmospheres. Okay students, pause this video and try to solve the answer. 1, 2, 3. I hope that you have solved the answer. I am going to explain now. So 5 grams So what he has said, that 5% weight by volume means weight in volume, right? 5 grams is present in 100 ml solution. So pi is equal to mRT and m is nothing but n by v. 5 grams he has mentioned, so it is 5 by 342. You have got moles by volume. Volume it is in 100 ml, so you will convert into liters. So it is 1000 by 100 into 0.0821 into 288. Then you will be getting approximately answer as 3.4. Okay, students, take one more question. 200 cubic centimeters of aqueous solution contains 1.26 grams of a polymer. You are containing a polymer, right? The osmotic pressure of this solution is 2.6 into 10 power minus 3 atmospheres at 300 Kelvin. Calculate the molar mass of the polymer. Option A is 50,000 gram per mole. Next, it is 60,000 gram per mole, 70,000 gram per mole, and 80,000 gram per mole. Okay? Pause the video. Try to solve the answer, students. 1, 2, 3. I hope that you have done this. So, pi is equal to mRT. M is nothing but number of moles per volume into RT. Pi, he has given 2.6 into 10 power minus 3. Weight. Number of moles means weight by molecular weight, 1.26 by x. That is what you have to find out the molecular weight of this one. Into volume is 200, so it is in ml. So, it is 1000 by 200 into 0.0821 into 300. So, that if you calculate the answer will be 60,000 gram per mole. This is what same the gaseous ideal gas equation formula only you will be getting. By using that you will be getting all the answers. There are some terms called as isotonic solution. Iso means same, tonic means concentration. If two solutions are having same concentration, then those two solutions are called as isotonic solution. Again, I am repeating, if two solutions are having same concentration, then those two solutions are called as isotonic solution. Two solutions are having same osmotic pressure. So concentration of this pressure of 1, 1, pi 1 should be equal to pi 2. Pi 1 is nothing but m1 rt1. It should be equal to m2 rt2. Hypertonic means a solution with less osmotic pressure. If I say a solution of pi 1 having is hypotonic with pi 2 means pi 1 is having less osmotic pressure compared to pi 2. In the same way, hypertonic means more osmotic pressure. If pi 1 is hypertonic over pi 2 means what does that indicate? So pi 1 is having more osmotic pressure compared to the pi 2. Okay, let us take one question with respect to this one. A 5% weight by volume cane sugar is isotonic. Isotonic means a solution with the same concentration with what it is having 0.877% urea solution. Cane sugar solution is in isotonic with urea solution. See, weight is different. Okay, if molar mass of the cane sugar, he is mentioning here for cane sugar, molar mass is 342. Calculate the molar mass of the urea. So what he is telling, pi 1 of cane sugar is equal to pi 2 of urea. Okay, pi 1 is nothing but m1 rt1 m2 rt2. As he has not mentioned temperature also, temperature is also constant. So you can write this, rr is common, m1 is equal to m2. Cane sugar means 5% he is telling here. 5% means 5 grams in 100 ml solution. Here urea, percentage is mentioning, means 0.877 grams in 100 ml solution. Okay. Now M1 is equal to M2 and M1, N1 by V1 is should be equal to N2 by V2. Volume also same. See here 100 ml, here also 100 ml. So V also same. V1 is equal to V2, that is also common. So N1 should be equal to N2 and N1 is nothing but weight by molecular weight. So it is 5 by 342 is equal to N2 is nothing but 0.877 by x molecular weight you require that one. So on calculating that, x will be getting 60. Okay, students, with respect to the isotonic solutions, you will make the pressure equal, right? And there is one more term called as reverse osmosis. See, generally what happens if you are applying pressure here, means whatever the pressure of this one is present, so as to not permit the solvent molecules to enter into this one, you are applying extra pressure. Okay, this is called as osmotic pressure. See, in this solvent molecules are there, in this solution is present. If nothing is present here, what happens? Solvent molecules comes into this one, so that they exert pressure on the piston. Okay, this one will move up. Now what we are doing is, instead of, first you have taken solvent as well as the solution, the solvent molecules tries to enter into this one, so that exerts pressure on this. So you have placed some pressure so that the solvent molecules will not enter into this one. Okay, means it is balancing. So it is balancing means the molecules are not entering into this one also is not entering into this one. Okay, solvent molecules, see, osmotic pressure means, osmosis means, the solvent molecules may enter from here to here, or the solvent molecules of this solution may enter from here to here. Both are accepted. Generally from low concentration to high concentration will occur. Generally from low concentration to high concentration, solvent molecules will be coming. That movement of solvent molecules you are stopping by giving extra pressure. Okay, means you are providing extra here. By, so that what happens, the solvent molecules entering into this solution is stopped. Now means that is at equilibrium, means solvent molecules is not entering here. Now what you are doing is you are adding extra pressure on this one. Now it is in equilibrium only. Now you are adding extra pressure, so that what happens from here, the solvent molecules of this solution will move from here to here. Okay, what happens? Only solute particles remain here. The concentration of this solution will be still more increased, because due to increasing the pressure, the solvent particles will be moving from high concentration to the low concentration. See, osmosis from low concentration to high concentration. Reverse osmosis means from high concentration to the low concentration due to external pressure. You are providing more amount of pressure on the solution, so that the solvent molecules will be moving from high concentration to the low concentration through a semi-permeable membrane. Okay, means we are saying that this process, it is called as reverse osmosis. And basically, reverse osmosis process is a non-spontaneous process, because external agent should be provided continuously. So at P atmosphere plus pi, means atmospheric pressure will be present basically on the solution, along with that osmotic pressure we are providing. Osmosis is stopped. Okay, up to here it is okay. If we apply more pressure, so apart from this one, atmospheric pressure plus pi, whatever that you are providing to stop the osmosis, that is pi. Apart from that, you are providing extra pressure on this one. So that what happens? The solvent molecules from the solution side move into the lesser one, lesser concentration side. So that the osmosis is reversed. That is called as RO. This you can see on your Kent. You will be having Purit as a water purifier in your homes, right? And that it will be mentioned as RO. RO means reverse osmosis. So if you take salt water and you keep in your Purit or something Kent instrument, what happens? That salt has been removed and the pure water comes into this one, so that you can collect here and you can drink it. This is what that will be occurring in our aqua water container, something you will be having in your homes. In that RO process will be occurring, means reverse osmosis will be occurring. Thus RO is used for desalination of seawater. Suppose if you take seawater and you apply extra pressure from this side, only water molecules comes here and the salt particles will remain here. So means for purifying the seawater, you can use reverse osmosis process. Okay, and osmotic pressure of the mixture of two solutions, there are now, which till now we have learnt only with respect to only one type of solution. Now two solutions. Case one, if two solutions are made up of same substance having different osmotic pressures, you are having one container with osmotic pressure pi 1, another container with osmotic pressure pi 2, but both are sugar solutions only. Now what happens if you mix? What will be the resultant osmotic pressure? Means pi 1 v 1 will be equal plus pi 2 v 2 will be equal to pi resultant volume. So pi resultant volume is v1 plus v2. So this is by using this formula we can solve this. When two solutions are of same solute particles having different osmotic pressures. And second case, in one container you are having number of n1 moles and another containing number of n2 moles, but of different solutes. In the above case, we have learnt that is same solute, same type of solute. Here, if you are going for the different types of solute, let N1 and N2 are the number of moles of two different solutes present with and V1 volume and N2 with V2 volumes respectively. Now, on mixing these two, see, you are having different types of solutes here. Now, you are mixing those two. He is asking the osmotic pressure of the resultant solution. Then, pi is equal to pi 1 plus pi 2. Pi is equal to N1 I1 RT by V1 plus V2, N2 I2 R2 by V1 plus V2. You can write as N1 I1 plus N2 I2, RT is taken as common by V1 plus V2. Don't get confused with what are I1 and I2. I1 and I2 are the Van 't Hoff factors of the two solutes, and you'll be getting clear idea with respect to this one in the next upcoming video, that is Van 't Hoff factor. This is for this for today, students. Prepare well and solve the problems whatever that are in your material as well as the modules. Okay, have a nice day. Bye bye. Stay home, stay safe.